So let me move to the representative of the RAL Foundation International.
Thank you, Madam President. Cancer is an attack. Cancer is usually attacked at its source using chemotherapy. The results are very tough on the human body, but physicians deem it necessary to save the lives of the person's infected. And before someone usually realizes they have cancer, they usually have to, you know, see signs, and they have to go to the doctor to kind of get it revealed. Human rights violations in regards to rule of law have led to the injustices for religious minorities, the sexual abuse of children, terrorism, ethnic cleansings, to name a few things. But these are not the problem. These are the results of the problem. The cause or the cancer is actually that actually results in the assault of human rights and the rule of law. Our mainstream religious organizations who use their political influence to impact the application of law and impede justice internationally to advance the religious and political agenda at the cost of human rights. My recommendations are as follows. Based under the Human Rights Articles 19, under the Human Rights Declaration, which states that a state party invokes the legitimate grounds for restrictions of freedom of expression and must demonstrate in specific and individualized fashion according to the precise nature of the threat. In other words, religious organizations can have their rights revoked and restricted if it is deemed a threat to the state. Threatened by the rule of law and the failure to implement and fairly apply the laws of religious minority groups resulting in the discrimination, ethnic cleansing, domestic and international terrorism. My recommendation is that all country members of the United Nations give their full support to the United Nations to enact Article 19 by halting all public operations of religious organizations and the immediate closure of all churches, temples, shrines, and mosques that have willfully violated the Declaration of Human Rights, Article 19. Although these are drastic measures at this point, I feel it's necessary if we are ever going to see a world free of human rights violations and religious bigotry. My last recommendation is as follows, that the United Nations immediately prohibit religious involvement in political affairs, that require that political entities immediately cut ties with religious entities, including the Vatican, the Russian Orthodox Church, and other religious organizations who have used their religious influence to persecute the religious minorities in their countries around the world. Their political involvement must be eliminated under the International Convention of Civil and Political Rights articles adopted by the United Nations in 1966. Although these are drastic measures to take, I believe it is necessary if we are ever to see a world free of religious bigotry and true peace and security internationally. Thank you, Madam President.
Thank you.